Prayer should be the key of the day and lock of the night. God can handle your doubt, anger, fear, grief, confusion, and your questions. You can bring everything to Him. So I invite Ayana for the opening prayer.
എല്ലാവർക്കും ഒരു നിമിഷം കണ്ണുകൾ അടയ്ക്കാം, പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. ഞങ്ങളെ അതിവാത്സല്യമായി സ്നേഹിക്കുന്ന ഞങ്ങളുടെ വാഴ്ത്തപ്പെട്ട സ്വർഗസ്ഥ പിതാവാം ദൈവമേ അപ്പ, ഈ ഒരു ദിവസം കൂടെ കാണുവാനും കർത്താവെ പലയിടങ്ങളിലായിരുന്ന ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അങ്ങയുടെ നാമത്തിൽ പ്രേസ് ആൻഡ് വർഷിപ്പായി ഒന്നിച്ചു കൂടുവാൻ അങ്ങ് നൽകിയ വലിയേറിയ അവസരത്തിനായി ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങേ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. നാഥ, എത്രയോ പേർക്കപ്പ ഇങ്ങനൊരു അവസരം ലഭിക്കാതെ അനേകമായ കഷ്ടങ്ങളാലും ദുരിതങ്ങളാലും രോഗത്താലും മരണത്താലും ഒക്കെ ആയിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങളെയും ഞങ്ങൾക്കുള്ളവരെയും അങ്ങ് ഇത്രയും കരുണയോടെ കാത്തു സൂക്ഷിച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന ഞങ്ങളുടെ വലിയ ദയക്കായിട്ട് നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവെ. ഇന്നത്തെ ആരാധന ഞങ്ങളുടെ കരങ്ങളിലേക്ക് തരുന്നു നാഥ. വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന ഓരോ മക്കളെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കരങ്ങളിൽ തരുന്നു നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ആവശ്യങ്ങൾ എന്താണെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ കുമ്പായി അറിഞ്ഞിരിക്കാൻ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവെ. ആവശ്യങ്ങളേറ്റ അനുഗ്രഹങ്ങളാൽ നിറയ്ക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവെ. ആരാധനയുടെ ഓരോ ഭാഗങ്ങൾ ഏറ്റെടുത്ത് നടത്തുന്നവരെയും അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ കർത്താവെ. അങ്ങ് തന്നെ അവരിലൂടെ സംസാരിക്കണമേ, ഇടപെടണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവെ. വെറുതെ വന്നവരായിട്ടല്ല കർത്താവെ, ദൈവമേ അങ്ങയുടെ സാന്നിധ്യവും സമാധാനവും അനുഭവിച്ചവരായി തന്നെ മടങ്ങുവാൻ ഞങ്ങൾ ഓരോരുത്തരെയും ഒരുക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാ കാര്യാദികളിലും ദൈവമേ അങ്ങയുടെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും കൂടെ ഉണ്ടായിരിക്കണമേ. ആരാധനയുടെ ആദ്യോടന്തം അങ്ങയുടെ കൃപ പകരണമേ. എല്ലാം അങ്ങയുടെ കരങ്ങളിൽ തരുന്നു. ക്രിസ്തു മൂലം പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണം നല്ല പിതാവേ. ആമേൻ.
With praise and thanksgiving, they sang to the Lord. He is good. His love toward Israel endures forever. And all the people gave a great shout of praise to the Lord because the foundation of the house of the Lord was laid. Let's also sing praise to God. So I invite Lime, Chichi and Feba for the song.
Nyan ninne kai vidumu oru naalum marukkumu nyan ninne kai vidumu oru naalum marukkumu amma marannalum marakkathavan andhithoolam koodi ullavan amma marannalum marakkathavan andhithoolam കൂടെയുള്ളവൻ ഞാൻ നിന്നെ കൈവിടുമോ ഒരു നാളും മറക്കുമോ ഞാൻ നിന്നെ കൈവിടുമോ ഒരു നാളും മറക്കുമോ കാക്കയാലാ നൽകിയവൻ കാടപ്പക്ഷികളാൽ പോറ്റിയവൻ കാക്കയാൽ ആഹാരം നൽകിയവൻ കാടപ്പക്ഷികളാൽ പോറ്റിയവൻ കാണുന്നവൻ എല്ലാം അറിയുന്നവൻ കൺമണി പോലെന്നെ കാക്കുന്നവൻ കാണുന്നവൻ എല്ലാം അറിയുന്നവൻ കൺമണി പോലെന്നെ കാക്കുന്നവൻ ഞാൻ നിന്നെ കൈവിടുമോ ഒരു നാളും മറക്കുമോ ഞാൻ നിന്നെ കൈവിടുമോ ഒരു നാളും മറക്കുമോ.
പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ, യാചന നൽകണമേ കർത്താവേ, യാചന നൽകണമേ. പുത്രന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ ചോദിക്കും കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഉത്തരം തന്നരുളാമെന്നുള്ള വാഗ്ദത്തം പോൽ ദയവായി ഇന്നുള്ളൊരു വാഗ്ദത്തം പോൽ ദയവായി പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണമേ കർത്താവിൻ യാചന നൽകണമേ കർത്താവിൻ യാചന നൽകണമേ താതനും മാതാവും നീനിക്കല്ലാതെ ഭൂതലം തന്നിലില്ലേ വേറാരുമെൻ ആതങ്കം നീക്കിടുവാൻ വേറാരുമിൻ ആതങ്കം നീക്കിടുവാൻ പ്രാർത്ഥന കേൾക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ യാചന നൽകണമേ കർത്താവേ യാചന നൽകണമേ
When life is rough, pray to God. When life is great, pray to God. Prayer is the key to God. I invite Meenu for the intercessory prayer.
തലക്കളെ വണക്കം. നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. ഞങ്ങൾ അതിവാത്സല്യമായി സ്നേഹിക്കുന്ന സ്വർഗീയ നല്ല പിതാവെ, നാഥ, വീണ്ടും ഒരു ബുധനാഴ്ച കൂടെ പ്രൈസ് ആൻഡ് വർഷിപ്പായി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഓരോരുത്തർക്കും അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധിയിലായിരിക്കാൻ സഹായിച്ച വിലയേറിയ ദയക്കായി നന്ദി പറയുന്നു. അതോ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, അപ്പച്ച സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. നാഥ, എത്രയോ മക്കൾ ഈ ലോകത്ത് നെടുക്കപ്പെട്ടപ്പോൾ നാഥ പാപികളും ദോഷികളുമായ അടിയങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരു ദിവസം കൂടെ കാണുവാൻ അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധിയിലായിരിക്കാനും അപ്പൻ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ച അനുവദിച്ച വിലയേറിയ ദയക്കായി നന്ദി പറയുന്നു. അത സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, അപ്പച്ച സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. അത ഞങ്ങളുടെ കോളേജിന് അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധി സമർപ്പിച്ച് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന അത കോളേജിൻ്റെ ഓരോ ആവശ്യങ്ങളിലും ഇന്നയോളം അപ്പൻ്റെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും കൂടെ ഇരുന്ന് എല്ലാ ആവശ്യങ്ങളും നടത്തി അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിച്ച വിലയേറിയ ദയക്കായി നന്ദി പറയുന്നു. അത തുടർന്നും അപ്പൻ്റെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും ഓരോ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളിലും കൂടെ ഇരുന്ന് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമെന്നാഥ ഞങ്ങളെ പഠിപ്പിക്കുന്ന ഓരോ അധ്യാപകരെയും കോളേജിൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഓരോ ഡോക്ടേഴ്സിനെയും നാഥ, ഓരോ നേഴ്സിനെയും മറ്റു നോൺ ടീച്ചിങ് സ്റ്റാഫ്സ് നാഥ, എല്ലാവരെയും അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധി സമർപ്പിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, എല്ലാവരെയും അപ്പൻ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ച് കാത്തു പരിപാലിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, ആവശ്യമായ നന്മകളും അനുഗ്രഹങ്ങളും കൊണ്ട് നിറയ്ക്കണമേ നാഥ. രോഗികളായി ഭാരപ്പെടുന്ന ഓരോ മക്കളെ അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധി സമർപ്പിച്ച് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, രോഗങ്ങൾക്കെല്ലാം തക്ക വൈദ്യനായ അപ്പൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും പൂർണ്ണമായ സൗഖ്യവും ബല ആരോഗ്യം അപ്പൻ ദാനമായി കൊടുക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ചാപ്ലിൻസി ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റിനെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, ഓരോ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളിലും ഇന്നയോളം അപ്പം കൂടെ ഇരുന്ന വിലയേറിയ ദയക്കാൻ നന്ദി പറയുന്ന നാഥ, സ്തുതിക്കുന്ന നാഥ. എന്താണ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടതെന്ന് അപ്പം തന്നെ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് വഴി നടത്തണമേ നാഥ. അപ്പച്ച ഓരോ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളിലും നാഥ അതിന് നേതൃത്വം കൊടുക്കുന്ന ഓരോ മക്കളെ അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ചാപ്ലിൻസി ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റിലുള്ള ഓരോ അച്ഛന്മാരെയും ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, അവരെ അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ നാഥ. കുട്ടികൾക്ക് നല്ല രീതിയിലുള്ള നേതൃത്വം കൊടുക്കാൻ ഓരോരുത്തരെയും അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഇന്നത്തെ പ്രൈസ് ആൻഡ് വർഷിപ്പിൽ ഇതുവരെയും അപ്പൻ്റെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും കൂടെ ഇരുന്ന വിലയേറിയ ദയക്കായി നന്ദി പറയുന്ന നാഥ. അപ്പച്ച മെസ്സേജ് പറയുന്ന ഉഷാ മാമിനെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, അപ്പച്ച ഇന്ന് നമ്മൾ കേൾക്കുന്ന ഓരോ വചനങ്ങളും നാഥ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കാലിന് ദീപവും പാതയ്ക്ക് പ്രകാശവും അരിപ്പാൻ സഹായിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ പഠിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാ മക്കളെയും അപ്പൻ്റെ തിരുസന്ധി സമർപ്പിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, പരീക്ഷകൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി ഒരുങ്ങുന്ന മക്കളുണ്ട് നാഥ, എല്ലാവരെയും അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ശ്രദ്ധയോടെ പഠിച്ച് ശ്രദ്ധയോടെ പരീക്ഷകൾ എഴുതി നല്ല വിജയങ്ങൾ കരസ്ഥമാക്കി അപ്പന് സ്തുതി സ്തോത്രങ്ങൾ അർപ്പിക്കാനുള്ള കഴിവ് ആരോഗ്യവും കൊടുക്കണമേ നാഥ. പരീക്ഷാ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ എല്ലാ മക്കളെയും ആരോഗ്യത്തോടെ കാത്ത് പരിപാലിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ പാരൻസ്, സിബ്ലിങ്സ് എല്ലാവർക്കും വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, അവരായിരിക്കുന്ന ഇടങ്ങളിൽ അപ്പൻ്റെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും കൂടെ ഇരിക്കണമേ നാഥ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ രാജ്യത്തിനായി ദേശത്തിനായി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, പകർച്ചവ്യാധിയാൽ ഭാരപ്പെടുന്ന നാഥ, അനേക മക്കൾ വേദനയോട് കണ്ണുനീരോടെ ആയിരിക്കുന്ന നാഥ, അപ്പച്ച രോഗാണുക്കളെല്ലാം മാറ്റണമേ നാഥ, എങ്ങും സന്തോഷം സമാധാനം ഒന്ന് നൽകണമേ നാഥ. അപ്പച്ച ഈ പ്രൈസ് ആൻഡ് വർഷിപ്പിന്റെ ശേഷിച്ച സമയം അപ്പൻ്റെ കൃപയും സാന്നിധ്യവും കൂടെ ഇരുന്ന് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ നാഥ. എല്ലാം ഒരിക്കൽ കൂടെ യേശുവിന്റെ തിരുസന്ധി സമർപ്പിച്ച് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുമ്പോൾ എന്റെ യാചനക്കണ സ്വർഗീയ നല്ല പിതാവേ, ആമേൻ.
Bible is the only book whose author is always present when one reads it. I invite Sharon for the Bible reading.
Today's Bible portion is taken from 2 Kings 3, verse 7 to 20. He also sent his message to Jehoshaphat, king of Judah. The king of Moab has rebelled against me. Will you go with me to fight against Moab? I'll go with you, he replied. I am as you are, my people as your people. My horses are as your horses. By what route shall we attack? He asked. Through the desert of Aden, he answered. So the king of Israel set out with the king of Judah and the king of Edom. After a roundabout march of 7 days, the army had no more water for themselves or for the animals with them. What? Exclaimed the king of Israel. Has the Lord called us three kings together only to hand us over to Moab? But Jehoshaphat asked, is there no prophet of the Lord here that we may inquire of the Lord through him? An officer of the king of Israel answered, Elisha, son of Shaphat, is here. He asked, he used to pour water on the hands of Elijah. Jehoshaphat said, the word of the Lord is with him. So the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat and the king of Edom went down to him. Elisha said to the king of Israel, what do we have to do with each other? Go to the prophets of your father and the prophets of your mother. No, the king of Israel answered, because it was the Lord who called us three kings together to hand us over to Moab. Elisha said, as surely as the Lord Almighty lives, whom I serve, if I do not have respect for the presence of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah, I would not look at you or even notice you. But now bring me a harpist. While the harpist was playing, the hand of the Lord came upon Elisha, and he said, this is what the Lord says. Make this valley full of ditches, for this is what the Lord says. You will see neither wind nor rain, yet this valley will be filled with water, and you, your cattle and your other animals will drink. This is an easy thing in the eyes of the Lord. He will also hand Moab over to you. You will overthrow every fortified city and every major town. You will cut down every good tree, stop up in all springs, and ruin every good field with stones. The next morning, about the time for offering the sacrifice, there it was, water flowing from the direction of Edom, and the land was filled with water. Here ends the reading.
God speaks to those who take time to listen, and he listens to those who take time to pray. Today, we are going to hear the word of God through a spiritual mentor who led us in Bible studies, who is a very active member in our chaplaincy activities, and is a great gynecologist. I invite our own Dr. Usha ma'am for the word of God.
Good evening, everyone. After a long time, I'm here in the praise and worship. It'd be nice to be with you all. Shall we bow our heads and pray? It's not yet another message or yet another word of God through somebody. All that we need is a word from the heart of the Lord, a word directly from the Lord, what we have to do. It should come directly from him. So as we ask him, Lord, I do not want to listen anything from ma'am. It's not another praise and worship or another Bible study, Lord. I just want to hear from you. What is your expectation about me? I just want to know about it this evening. Shall we all look unto his face? Our God speaks. He will not send a single soul empty. If you come with longing, he is there to fill you and send you back. Our most loving Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this blessed time, Daddy. Thank you, Lord. You have led us thus far. You have enabled all the children, you protected, and you brought them back to the campus. So, Father, we thank you for that. Lord, as we meditate on your word, we pray that you'll open the eyes of our heart so that we'll be able to understand your word anew, Daddy. Completely surrendering us into your hands, speak to us, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we heard from the Bible reading, taking the portion from 2 Kings chapter 3, 7 to 20. here we see three kings are going to fight against a single king. One is king of Israel, king of Judah, and king of Edom. All three are going together to fight against king of Moab. So all three are going through the wilderness of Edom. So after 7 days of their marching around, they came to a time when there was no water. Same verse, 3rd chapter 9th verse says, there was no water for the army, nor for the animals that followed them. So here they are facing a crisis. Three kings are going together. They are going for a war. And on the way, they are meeting a situation where they are in a crisis. They don't have any water. So we see here three kings. All three face the same situation. All three face the same problem. But now we'll see how each one responded to the problem. That's what we are going to study today. First, coming to King of Israel. What did he say? As soon as he came to know that there is water, the first word that came from his mouth is, alas. Tamil, it said this, ayo. I do not know what's there in Malayalam. So first, a fearful sound from his heart. Ayo, what will I do next? There's no water. The next what he is saying is, for the Lord has called these three kings together to deliver them into the hand of Moab. So now they are going to fight against Moab. Now here King Israel is saying, we are going to be defeated. That is, Lord is going to hand this over to King of Moab. So the first thing that came from his mouth is a fearful word. And then he started talking negatively. He's going to for a war. Three kings are going to fight against a single king. Obviously, they'll win. But here he started negatively when he saw the situation. So this is how King of Israel responded to a crisis in his life. So next king, King of Edom, he also faced a similar situation. Here we don't see him opening his mouth at all. Nothing is said in the Bible. So he was silent. Normally when we go through difficult situations like this, when we are silent, it's like you are upset, you are discouraged, you have given up, and you know that you are going to fail. The situation, you are not going to win over the situation. So you are quiet, you do not know what to do. So one king is fearful and started talking negatively and is restless. You see another king who is very silent. Okay, fine. Happened this happened. We are going to fail. Let me give up. And we see the third king. The 11th verse starts with but. Though other two responded to the situation like this, one king responds differently. So he is asking, he's not bothered about what other two responded. He is asking, we may have to inquire of the Lord. So he's asking, is there any prophet in this place? So they said, yes, Elisha is there. So 12th verse, the king of Judah is saying, the word of the Lord is with him. So basically, the king of Judah is searching for God's word. In a crisis, in a critical situation, a difficult situation, when other two are responding differently, here you have a person who is searching for a word for this situation. So they went to, we all know that they went to Elisha and they told the situation and he prayed and is giving God's word back to them. So 16th verse, it says, thus says the Lord. So he got the word from the Lord and he is telling these kings, make this valley full of ditches. You shall not see wind, nor shall you see rain yet. That valley shall be filled with water so that you, your cattle, and your animals may drink. And this is a simple matter in the sight of the Lord. So, King of Judah searched for God's word. He said, I'm not going to be fearful. I'm not going to be talking negatively. I'm not going to be depressed or discouraged about the situation. But I'll go and get Lord's word. I'll go to the Lord and see what he has to say about this situation. So he went in search of the Lord and he got the word. And the word says this is a simple matter in the sight of the Lord. So when you see the 20th word, it says, suddenly water came by way of Edom and the land was filled with water. Then when you read the subsequent verses, you'll happen to know that they won the battle. So here, all three face the same situation, but all three responded differently to the situation. If the king of Judah had also talked negatively or was quite accepting the failure, they would have lost the battle. Because one person stood up and said, I'm not going to see the situation, I'm not going to get discouraged, but I'm going to the Lord to get a word from him. So you got a word from the Lord and finally they ended up victoriously. So only one point I want to highlight this evening. Bible says the word of God is living and powerful. It's living today also. It's living. It's in the present. It's living. When a word is said, it can create. Genesis 1, we read, God said, and it was so. God said, and it was so. Everything was created by the powerful word of the Lord. That happens this day also. And it is powerful. It can do anything. When you read this verse, it says, even to piercing, even to the division of soul and the spirit. How will you differentiate? How will you separate the soul and the spirit? But it's even powerful to divide soul and spirit in a man. So word of God is living, or and the translation says it's active and it is powerful. So today I thought I'll share a few of my testimonies, how God leads you when you go to him and get a word. How are you able to go through a situation? Because I thought it's only 15 minutes. I just want to highlight this one situation you go through. First thing is, go to the Lord. Ask for a word. Bible has the answer to all your problems. Any problem you face, a silly problem to a big problem which you face in your life, Bible has the answer to it. Once you taste and see how good his words are, you will always run to it whenever you face difficulty in your life, or whenever you need an answer, you will run to it. So go to the word, get the answer from the word, because it is a living word. Even when the heaven and the earth passes away, Bible says his words will never pass away. We cannot imagine how a heaven will pass away, how an earth will pass away. It's impossible. Bible says even when the heaven and earth passes away, his word will never pass away. It will do its work, or it will do the purpose for which it is sent. So in any situation in this world, as God's children, don't turn to the world for answers. Don't run to another person for an answer. Always you'll be disappointed or discouraged. So take a decision this evening to run to him to get a word. Like how King of Judah went to a prophet, got God's word, and every crisis was solved and they won the battle. So a few examples I'll tell you from my life regarding studies and few things, so that you'll be able to, innumerable testimonies as I was sitting and thinking about how God led me through the word, how God took me out of the crisis in many of my life situation. There's so much. So only four or five I thought I'll share with you. Few years back, I had an elbow dislocation. So three weeks, they put a cast there. After third week, I started doing physiotherapy, cast was removed. So surgery and physiotherapy everywhere, they said, here, ma'am, your hand will not become, there will be some deformity, at least 10 or 15 degree deformity will be there. I searched through the net. Net also said most of the personal experiences of people who have gone through it have said there's some 10%, 15%. So I went to the Lord and I asked, Lord, what do you say about it, about this situation? God showed this verse to me. This is about a man with a shriveled hand. So Lord is, Jesus is telling the man to stretch out his hand, and Bible says it was completely restored, just as sound as the other. So that is what strengthened me. Just as sound as the other. When everyone says it will not recover completely, when your past experience or the experience of the others says it will not recover completely, but Bible says it will be completely restored, just as sound as the other. So I held on to this word. For the glory of the Lord, it got completely restored back to normal, just like the other hand. So this is about where you do not, though we are in the medical field, though we have medical knowledge, God does wonders beyond medical knowledge. There's so much. So I want to share more of my testimonies with my studies. So this is, I think it's in 2005, when I appeared for my DNB practical exam. It was in Pondicherry. As you all know, you'll have your practical in a place we are not familiar with. So you'll be alone there, you'll internal, external, nobody will be knowing you. So I went there. I said, Lord, you have delivered me from lion, from bear, and this Goliath will be like one of them. I'll easily walk through. So I went for the exam. Exam was really tough. By the time I finish my presentation, I know they'll fail me because it went on very badly. So afternoon, I thought I'll skip the viva because of the compulsion of my husband. I finished the viva that day. So on my way back, I was asking the Lord, Lord, because at the end of the exam, when the examiner gave back the logbook to me, he said the word to me, Doctor, you keep this safe for some more time. You have to come back again. So it's a word from an examiner saying that you have failed, you have to come back again. And my mind, my performance also, I know I will not clear. So on the way back, I was asking the Lord, Lord, Bible says we are always victorious in Christ. But examiner is saying, I have to come back again. Lord, what do you say about it? In the bus, Lord, Holy Spirit reminded this verse to me. This is where Jairus came to Jesus saying his daughter is sick. So Jesus is going along with Jairus. As they were traveling for some time, people from his home will come and say, don't bother the master, your daughter is already dead. So the next verse says, ignoring what they said. Some translation will say overhearing what they said, but this is NIV. Ignoring what they said, Jesus told him, don't be afraid, just believe. So the Lord reminded, the Holy Spirit reminded this verse in the bus that day. Ignore what the examiner says. Ignore the situation which says it's already dead. When the world says there is no hope, still there is a hope for God's children. So do not be afraid, just believe. It was very hard for me to believe then because I know how badly I performed. But God's word was so direct to me that day. Holy Spirit clearly spoke to me. Then I said, Lord, I ignore. Though the examiner said, I ignore. I do not know how my result will come as pass. You can do anything. You can change the computer number. You can change. I do not know how you are going to do it. But I just believe. If you can bring back Jairus' daughter back to life, you can change my fail to pass, though the examiner has failed me. So for the glory of the Lord, at the end of 3 months, when results came, out of 27, only 9 had passed, of which my name was there. My heart at least stopped for a second. So God can do anything. If he said, he will do it. So any situation before being fearful, before getting discouraged, before discussing with others, before getting a solution from this world, always run to the Lord. Get a word from Him. You'll be able to walk through any situation happily, however bad it may be, however discouraging it may be. I tell you. So He did not tell me that He will send somebody to help me or He'll be sending a senior, but He told me, I myself will help you. So there is such an encouragement from that day to this day. Any difficulty, any surgery, any difficult delivery, anything, this word will come to my mind. I myself will help me. Lord is so faithful in fulfilling that promise even to this day. Each day I'm tasting how He Himself is holding my hand and leading me. So any difficulty, anything which you're worried about, any silly matter or a big thing, just run to Him. Then because you're all studying, I want to tell this also. Again, during my PG period, third year, it was very difficult for me to comprehend the pelvic anatomy and the prolapse etiology, how it happens, how to correct the surgery. I will not understand how a vaginal hysterectomy is done. Even first, second year of PG, it was difficult for me. So third day, one day, I went to the Lord and asked, Lord, nobody is teaching properly. I'm not understanding anything. I do not know how I'll pass this exam. Lord showed me this verse. Here, Bible says, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things. It doesn't say He will teach you Bible, He will teach you about God. It says He will teach you all things, that includes your studies also. So that day I said, Holy Spirit, you teach me. I'm going to sit at your feet. You teach me this pelvic anatomy and the prolapse. I'll tell you so beautifully, Lord, enable me to understand that particular day. I mean, then taught everyone the next day what Lord taught me. Other thing is, finally, so much to study. There's still 5 or 6 months for the exam. How will you be able to revise again? So I used to tell Him, Lord, one of your characteristics, you are the one who reminds me of things. So I am studying this 5 months before the exam. I do not know whether I'll turn and see this again or not, but I am giving it in your hands. If the same question comes for the exam, you should remind me of this. But I tell you, that was a silly, silly prayer I prayed every day when I sat and studied. But for the glory of the Lord, at the end of my postings near the exam, I was able to recollect everything which I had studied 5 months, 6 months back. I was wondering, is it me or somebody else? Such a drastic change His word had done in my life. Then, I think I'll skip this. So, I'll encourage you all to read the word. Because unless you read the word, you'll be in a crisis. God should bring it to remembrance, a word at that particular crucial moment. So you should be reading. Read the word. Memorize and hide it in your heart. Bible says, hide it in your heart so that you will not sin against Him. Then, again, Bible says, let the word of God dwell in you richly. Ethra pattu athrim. Read the Bible every day. Spend some time with the Bible, asking Lord to teach you. Let it be your meditation day and night, not sitting always with the Bible. The one word which God had spoken in the morning, keep meditating on it as you go through your day that day. I tell you, you will never be the same. It's not about getting a head knowledge about the Bible. So much I know about the Bible, that's not important. Your life should be transformed by each and every word which you read. It should be living and powerful in your word, in your life. Should be transforming you. Any difficult situation, do not go to anyone, but go to the Lord. Get the word from Him. So you'll be able to easily walk through any problem you face this day. I do not know what you're facing or what difficulties you're going through, or not now, in your future when you go through. So as we start today, there are three choices you have. One, seeing a situation, you can be fearful, talk negatively, everything is gone, everything is over, I'm going to fail, I'm going to give this up. So instead of all that, this one option, like the king of Israel did, or like king of Edom, you can be quiet, discouraged, depressed without saying anything, giving up all your present situation. Or like Jehoshaphat, like the king of Judah, you can go to the Lord, get a word from him, and you can walk through the same situation happily, because you know God was promised is faithful. Once he has said, then it is so. No man can change it. So it's your choice. So make it a habit. Lord taught me this. So any crisis, any situation I face, I go to the Lord and ask him, Lord, give me a word. Give me a word. However tough it is, I'll be able to go through it if only you give me a word. So somehow God, through the word or directly or through somebody or through somehow he'll give me a word. You know that it is for you, because that will start, that will top your spirit. So that's my advice to my children this evening. Make it as a habit. Or what are you going through at present? Don't be fearful about it. Don't talk negative about it. Do not be discouraged. You are his child. He knows what you are going through. Just go to him. Get a word from him. And hold on to the word. That will never go wrong. Shall we pray? Look unto the Lord. What are you going through this evening? What is that troubling you this evening? Look unto him. God's word is living and powerful. It is active. It will never go wrong. It will never go wrong. The Bible is the answer to all your problems. Just search through the Bible. Just get the answer from the Bible. There is a word for you there. Hold on to it. God will speak to you. This is my child, your word. Hold on to it. That will come true. Ethra kaala agunnulladhu, sometimes we do not know. 1 day, 2 day, 1 week, 1 month, that we do not know. But that will come to pass. Like how God did in the life of Abraham, and so many examples we have in the Bible. So we'll tell him, Lord, from this day onwards, in every situation of mine, I'll run to you. I'll get a word from you. I'll stand on the word, and I'll go through any tough situation happily along with you, because I have the word in my hand. Loving Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this blessed evening, oh Father God. Thank you for your word, Daddy. It is a living word. It is an active word. It is a powerful word that can pierce our hearts, oh Father. Thank you for that. Lord, I commit every child who has listened to this message this evening, oh Lord. Katavya, whatever you want me to share, I have shared, oh Lord. Transform their lives, oh Father. Lord, for anything and everything, Lord, enable them to run to you, Daddy, get a word from you, and to stand on it. Let their lives be transformed like that, oh Father. Let them be different from this day on, Lord, Daddy. If they were like king of Israel or king of Edom so far, Lord, from this day onwards, their life be transformed like king of Judah, Daddy, who will not be bothered about what others are doing, but will run to you and to get a word, and will come out, and who comes out victoriously, O Master. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I bless every child this evening, Daddy. Bless them, O Father. Bless their time with you, Daddy. Bless their time with the Bible, Lord. You teach them, Lord. You speak to them. Lord, bless the studies, O Father. Bless their families, O Father God. Especially children who are preparing for the exams, Lord. Lord, you be with them. Holy Spirit, you teach them and guide them. Let them be blessed in every walk of their life. We give you all the glory, Daddy. In Jesus' most matchless name we pray. Amen.
As ma'am said, when you need an answer, seek God and you will get your answer. Thank you, ma'am, for the divine message. We also thank everyone
who attended this meeting, and we, the chaplaincy department, will always be there for you and will keep you all in our prayers. Be in God till we meet on next Wednesday. Thank you all for your wonderful presence. Have a nice day.
Thank you.